this is not one or two bad apples. This is a systemic cultural problem. There is a culture of violent misogyny that is allowed to flourish within the Met Police and within policing nationally. And until that is addressed through root and branch reform, how can any of us feel safe?
We'll see you in 5 minutes. Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Behaviour. Had any of those flags been picked up earlier, some of his crimes could have been prevented and women's lives could have been fundamentally different. How can we feel safe as women and girls in this city if that many officers are committing crimes and remaining in the force? How can good, hard-working officers feel proud to do their jobs if they have to work alongside criminals? We're calling for immediate zero tolerance to offending against women and girls within the police force. As soon as an officer faces any allegations of domestic abuse or sexual violence, they should be immediately suspended and investigated so that we as the public can feel confident that when we come forward to report crimes against us, we are not reporting them to a criminal. For a long time, we've been told the story that this is one or two bad apples, and that's why we've brought the metaphor here today. This is not one or two bad apples. This is a systemic cultural problem. There is a culture of violent misogyny that is allowed to flourish within the Met Police and within policing nationally. And until that is addressed through root and branch reform, how can any of us feel safe? What I think causes this is that we know some people are attracted to these kinds of jobs because they bring power and authority. They're able, just like David Carrick, about whom we heard appalling revelations this week, they're able to say, no one will believe you because I am a police officer. If someone does come forward and report, then it's their friends, their colleagues who investigate, and they're able to dismiss or minimise the crime. We know that police officers are a third less likely to be convicted of allegations made against them in relation to domestic abuse than general members of the public. So we know that there are real barriers that are in place for women who experience abuse at the hands of police officers. And so people are attracted to these jobs deliberately. The vetting is weak and they are allowed to get through. David Carrick faced allegations of domestic abuse before he even joined the police. The reality is he should never have become a police officer in the first place. He wasn't suitable to hold that kind of a role. And then there's not adequate training within the police either to understand or recognise these crimes, and therefore it becomes a systemic problem. Yeah, my message to the Home Secretary, Suella Braverman, today is that she has a real opportunity to make our streets safer for women and girls and to attract more people who should be serving into the jobs that we really need doing within the police force if she takes this zero tolerance approach. And if she says, on top of all the inquiries that she's announced and that we've already had, if she says from now on, when an officer faces these kinds of accusations of violence against women and girls, they will be suspended and they will be investigated. That feels like a very reasonable request for us and a vital first step to restoring faith in policing.